Okay, welcome back. This is the fifth video in the series we're doing so far, and today I want to talk about staff. So I want to ask Piers how he's managed to keep, especially one of his staff stood right there, Gerard, for such a long time, and why it's important to really look after your staff.
Yeah, so, well, the way I look at it is, like, I'm not here 24/7. I'm not coaching every single session. I'm not responsible for doing the check-ins with every single client. So if I don't have good staff around me, the gym isn't successful, because if they're not doing things the way we like things to be done, and they're sort of slacking or they're not showing up for sessions, like, that's, the clients see those things, you know, the clients pick up on that, and then it leads to clients leaving. So for me, like, we'll mention Jerk, because he's been with me for the longest. Another really good coach in at the minute, Anto, who's only been with us for, I think Anto's here a month now. Jared's been with me for 7 or 8 months, so we've only been just open over a year, so that's a long time in our. And I tell him all the time, like, I couldn't run the gym without him. He's very reliable. He's on board with my vision. He understands what I'm trying to grow the gym to be. He'll come in and do things outside of his working hours. Like, he's in here right now. We don't have sessions until 4:15, and he's in here doing check-ins with clients. So yeah, he'd go out of his way, same as Anto. Anto was in earlier this morning and stayed behind for 2 hours after his coaching to do check-ins with clients. So, like, staff is so important. Like you mentioned, if you have staff messaging you 5 minutes before, like, yeah, I would be sacking someone for that too, because, like, it leaves you in a bad place. You might end up, you know, you might not even be on site, but next thing you're getting a phone call, you have to jump in and coach. And if you're late, then there's a session that could be missed, and that's the sort of stuff that, like, even one case of that could lose you 5-6 clients. So it's key to get good staff on board. It's hard to do, because there's that many personal trainers out there, and, you know, someone could come in and initially they might sort of sing off the same hymn sheet as you, and as time goes on they get lazy, they start doing things they shouldn't be doing. So trying to get staff who are continuously good is tough, but yeah, I think with the team I have at the minute, we're quite fortunate that way.
So what are you doing then to make sure that they stick with your vision, they keep believing, and they actually want to support you? Do you have, like, coaching development programs? Do you have week or monthly staff meetings? What is it that keeps them?
Yeah, so we do a weekly meeting, which has a structure to it. So it's not like we're kind of just meeting up and winging it. So we have a set structure. We have continuous development. So just recently, I actually had Jordan Anto over in Meg Waywell's gym, Steve Habitat, on a business walkthrough, so that they can sort of see what goes on in the background of a business, so they appreciate what I do. Because there is a lot that goes on, you know, as well as obviously me still coaching, I have 150 clients I'm responsible for. I have to make sure the business is running right, I have to make sure I'm paying the bills. But yeah, I've taken them away a couple of times. We've went on coaching foundation courses. The guys know if they want to go away and further educate themselves that there's a budget there for that. There's opportunity for progression working here. But for me, I think the best thing is actually letting them know, so where I want the gym to be, and keeping them up to date with where we're currently at, so they're on board with the growth of the business. You know, rather than me keep that stuff secret and not telling them, like, where we're at and where I want to be, by just being open with them and telling them, like, this is my vision for the gym, this is where we're currently at, this is what we need to do to get there. It gets them a lot more on board with the whole process, rather than me just keeping that stuff to myself and relying on myself to get there. The boys have been great for helping me. You know, that they're in here a lot coaching when I'm not, and the clients absolutely love them. So if it wasn't for that, then we wouldn't be where we are today. So yeah, coaches have been great.
Thanks for watching. Now come join us inside our free Facebook group, where on a daily basis we share tons of content to help you generate leads for your fitness business.